In this video, I'm going to show you how you can connect your Webflow environment to cursorai, creating a very efficient workflow where you can iterate on your JavaScript and update in real time on your Webflow project. This is a game changer for me. It has been helping me create very cool animations very quickly without having to go back and forth between other tools and other AIs. So without boring you with all this talk, let's see how this is done. So first, let me introduce you to cursorai. It's an AI code editor. I think it's one of the best out there, if not the best. It can read your files, you can choose different models, and it can iterate on your code very efficiently. It has different versions like a chat and composer, which gives you different type of results, being recommended by a lot of developers and a lot of companies out there. I've used it a lot. I've made another video. I'm going to link it here somewhere and you guys can check it out. However, in this video, we're going to see how we can use this on our Webflow project and how it can help us create JavaScript codes. So first things first, of course, you need to download it. I have it for Mac. You can download it for Windows or Linux. And then once you have it, you can see it's a desktop tool. So you can check it out here. It has this UI. Now, what we need is another thing, which is Webflow, of course. We need our Webflow project. So right now I have this template. It's been pulled from Reloom, which we'll make another video about. Very cool AI updates. So I have this simple website, just basic stuff that is built in Webflow. Now what I want to do is I want to animate everything here. So nothing here is animated and I want to add some animations first thing and perhaps maybe some pop-ups to some buttons. So I'm going to set up a pop-up button that appears when I click here. So let's see how to do that. Now first thing, to animate this, of course, I can animate section by section or ID by ID, and then I can go to the cursor and tell it, hey, animate this for me. Or I can use something much faster, which is just I can export the code. So if I go to export code, Webflow prepares an HTML, CSS, JavaScript, an asset file for me in a zip format. So I can download the zip format. And if I open it here, we can see that okay, this is Reloom template one. You can see the 404, 401, the index, which is the homepage, and the style guide, which is the other page. I have the CSS files, the JavaScript files, everything is here. So this would be perfect to start off on my cursor project. So let's go back to cursor and I'm going to open project and I'm going to choose the file that I just downloaded, which is Reloom template one, and I'm going to open it. Now you can see this is a very default view of a code editor, very similar to Visual Studio Code Editor, which is a very famous one. However, we have this side panel, which is basically the AI. And as you can see, you can choose from a list of different models. Now you can set these up. I've chose these models to see all the time. And then perhaps I'm going to bring in a terminal just in case. I'll make this smaller. And now I can start iterating on my website. Now, what I want to do is I want to create a new file. And I'm going to call this animations.js. And this will be the file that I will connect to Webflow. And this is the JavaScript file that we'll animate with now. What I want to do is I'm going to go to the composer and I'm going to add files. So these are the files that I want the composer to be aware of. First, I'm going to add the index.html, which is the home page, and I'm going to add the style guide as well. Style guide, and of course the animation file. So wait, let's bring up the index. The index, style guide, and animation file. And now I can start prompting. Okay, so I prepared the prompt. Now my prompt is going to be read my files, understand how the structure of my website is built, then create a set of subtle modern animations for the different elements on my site. So it's going to read all my elements on my site and give me some animation. Do not attempt to change anything in the HTML or style guide files because I don't want to change anything there. These are fixed files that I exported from Webflow. And then I tell it, use GSAP and other recommended libraries. Give me the CDNs code separately. So I need the code separately. I don't like to import them here. So I'll just add them directly on the Webflow project and then it will be pulled from there. And now I can go ahead. Now I like using the agent mode and it's pretty powerful. It's pretty much faster. It resolves error by on its own. However, this is something maybe you can test out. There are different types of model. 3.5 Sonnet is really good nowadays.
So let's use it. Let's try with Sonnet. All right, so it's reading my files. It's reading the directory. I want this file. It's reading my index. It's continuing to read line 300, 400. How many lines do I have in this index file? Whoa, it's huge. So it analyzed everything, and now it's creating a set of subtle animation. So the good thing about the agent mode is that it kind of gives itself a task to do, or breaks down the task like it did here. So it broke down the index.html file into different 100 lines. So it read it 100 lines at a time, which is great. And this definitely improves efficiency in the result. Let's see how that result comes out. Of course, this is AI, so we don't know what's going to happen. Kind of give it the rules and hope for the best. All right, so now we have it here. As you can see, it's naming all my classes. So it knows my navbar 3 logo. This is a reloom names, header 9, content left. All these are named properly, which is great. It gives me some animations. If you're liking this type of content, make sure to subscribe to the channel, give this video a thumbs up, and stay tuned on what's coming next. And let's get back to work now. So let's accept this file. And now let's install this on Webflow. So I'm going to copy this. And yeah, so these are the CDNs. As I told it, I wanted the CDNs separately. So I'm going to go back to my project. I'm going to close this. And then we'll install the CDNs and connect our cursor. So GSAP core, this is there. GSAP scroll trigger, scroll to plugin for smooth scrolling. Okay. And then your animation just JS file. This is not going to be like that. So it's correct script, but we need to give it more options, more parameters. Type module. And then the source will be live server. So what we're going to do is we're going to put this on a live server that works on our local environment. And that's how we're going to connect everything without having to use a CDN, which we can do. If later on we want to publish this, we can use a CDN or perhaps host it on GitHub and then use a CDN to pull it through. However, for this video and for development purposes on my local environment, I like to do this live. This way I don't have to use any other tools or services. So I have this already set up, but you can go to extensions here and you can look for live server. And then you can find it here, live server. It's the one that has over 60 million downloads. You install it. I already have it installed. And that's basically it. So once you have the live server, you can click on go live. And as you can see, it pushed the website live. So I have this server extension. So I'm going to look for index.js. No, actually not index. We are animations.js. So this is my animations file. As you can see, I can see it here. It's the same one that is here. I'm going to copy this URL and then I'm going to go back to my project. And instead of this source, I'm just going to give it this URL. And then I'm going to save. Everything looks good. And then I'm going to publish. Now, once you install new libraries or you change the, let's say, the port number or something like that, you will need to publish from Webflow, and then you go on your site. But now once I make changes on the code on the live server or on cursor, I don't need to publish again. All I have to do is just refresh. But now, as you can see, we have something here going on. So as you can see, there's this animation of the thing zooming in, text animations, which is great. I have a hover animation here, which is great. All the images have a hover animation. Somehow my button's not looking there. And yeah, everything is looking good. Now I have this one by one stacking up. The buttons are looking weird. I think we can start talking to it about this. Also, this parallax effect for the homepage might not fit very much. And now it's all about me going back to cursor and working with what it has. Okay, so I've told it my buttons are not working, so they're hiding when they shouldn't, and then to remove the parallax effect. I also noticed this here, which is the three buttons next to each other, and only two of them are animating. And for this, I can go and inspect, of course, I can just see how this is worked out. So I want navbar. Yeah, so now I can just copy this, and this is the class name or the ID name. I mean, that works, both work. Or perhaps I can copy the parent element. However, Let's copy one of them and let's go back to cursor. We'll tell it, and we can add a button dot here so it knows this is a class. What's this one called? All right, so we gave it three tasks: my buttons, the parallax effects, and the navbar 3. Now, since this is an agent mode, I like to do this. I tend to think a lot, so I want things done quickly. However, it's always good, of course, to break it down. The agent will do that on its own because, again, it's an agent mode. So this is very smooth and it's a very easy thing to do, to just give it as much as you can, of course, in moderation. So now, as you can see, it's let's fix your animation file and then your social icon hover animation to use the same improved. Okay, so it's improving some approaches. Great. Let's improve the menu animation to ensure they work properly. So it's working its way through this. All right, so it generated all of them. And now I can, of course, I can review the codes that it generated. I can see them here. The red one is something that deleted, and the green stuff is added. So let's accept the file. Let's go back. We just need to refresh. As you can see now, the menu is working properly, which is great. The parallax effect is gone, so this is not overlapping anymore, and things are looking better. Some glitches here. But that's fine. Some glitches still in the button. So that's the idea. Now I can go back and forth between Cursor AI and chat with it and improve on my website. It's great because you can just basically split screen, keep chatting, and iterate on the website. This is happening real time. So as soon as I refresh, things are updating right away. So I can go ahead now and create something else. Let's say I want to create a pop-up whenever I click on this button. Let's go back to Workflow. I just want to check this button. So this is button is secondary. Okay, so whenever I click on the secondary button, I want a pop-up to appear. Okay, so I have this prompt. So whenever I click on button is secondary, I want there to be a pop-up that says AI is a game changer and a nice icon on the top. So let's see how that is done. Let's give it the prompt. It's going to add a pop-up feature. So what do you do between prompts? So when you prompt and wait for your answer to come out, what do you do? Let me know in the comments. I would love to know. All right, so we have a pop-up feature. Cool. It finished generating. I've added a beautiful pop-up. Okay, very beautiful. Let's go back. Let's refresh. Let's test this out. So if I click on nice. So I have this pop-up going on. It's even the pop-up is animated, which is great. This thing is bugging, so we can check it out. I just want to test this button as well. It's there, but it's not showing. Now there could be another animation affecting this element, and that sometimes causes a glitch. However, this is something you can keep iterating on until you get it fixed. It's always good to use the inspect tool to check the classes of the stuff that you want to change. And of course, it's always good to go back to your code and just check what is there, what is happening. Now, another thing that is fun to do, and I don't want to take long time of this video, say I want to change this into a slider. So let's inspect this element. Now, what I have, this element is called Team 6 List Wrapper. So this is it. All right, so I told it that I want a Swiper.js slider or any other library slider, and I want to update this list with whatever is inside it, because this basically has 6 items inside, but we don't need to specify that. And then we can submit. Let's see how it's going to make our slider. I haven't tested this, and I'm excited to see the result that's going to come out of it. I hope I won't have to delete this part of the video. So let's see. All right, it's applying, it's dragging. We have team slider to implement. All right, and I have the CDN. Of course, I need to install that, so I'm going to copy that. I'm going to go to my project, and I'm just going to paste this with the rest. Now, if you're using CDNs across your project, I would recommend pasting these in the project settings, so that you don't have to keep going back and forth between them, and then just keeping them there, and then using your GSAP library across the website, or like say swiper slider in this case. So let's publish and let's accept this code. So you always have to accept the iterations or the codes that Cursor gives you. Otherwise it will not update. So we have published, so we can go back, we can refresh. Let's see how this works out. Ooh, okay, so we have a slider going on, but I think it's because of the animation that's happening, the slider is not showing. So let's tell it, remove the animations. All right, let's submit. So I want to remove all the animations from the slider children because I want to see the slider. I know it's there, so that's great. This is working, but because there is an animation on the image itself, this is not showing. So let's go back. Let's see what Cursor gives us. All right, so this is a nice use case. Here it created something and then there were some problems, so some errors, and it found those lints, those errors, and then it fixed them on its own. I didn't have to tell it anything. And this is a great thing about agent mode, is that it does this type of stuff, that it just fixes itself. It makes sure that there are no errors, no problems, no bugs popping up, and then gives you the code. So let's accept. Let's go back to our project. Let's refresh. And now I have my slider. It's not showing 3 per slides, and I think because of my viewport. Could it be? It's not. It's just not showing 3 per slide. I think the AI just wanted to rebel and shows me 2 per slide. However, you can just go back and tell it I want to show. So I prompted that I want to show 3 slides per view on desktop, 1 slide on mobile. It's generating that code for me, so I know it's going to add breakpoints properties to Swiper.js, and then it will animate. So accept file. Let's see if this works out. Great, it's working. 3 slides per view, which is fantastic. There's the pagination and there's the sliders, the arrows. So this is all great. Fantastic. Now that we're done with the changes, we can either save this, let's say push it to our GitHub, and then use a CDN like JS Deliver. I have done videos about this. I'm going to leave them in the description or somewhere here on how to connect your custom code to Webflow. However, you can always just go copy this entire thing and then go back to your Webflow project. And instead of having this script module, you can just delete this one and then you can paste it in here. Now this works, of course, and it's great because you can still iterate on your code here. However, another better scenario would be to upload a text file into the platform and then using that as the source. This is, of course, a free way and a very efficient way to do this without having to, you know, put a lot of codes here in your project settings. However, for the sake of this tutorial, we're going to save this like that, and I'm going to leave this project for you as a clonable so you guys can check it out and see how it works out. That's it for today. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.